What do you think about when you hear the word sin? I think for all of us, our minds go a thousand different directions when we hear that word. And I'll be talking to people and they'll give me their answer. And some people will say, Jonathan, we are deep down inside, we're good people. All of us are. Humanity is good. We just sometimes make bad decisions. That they would kind of argue that if we would just learn from those mistakes and make better decisions, we can eventually become just good all around. Other people will say, yes, we all make mistakes, we're all sinners, but if my sin is not as bad as somebody else's sin, I must be a good person in comparison to that person. So in other words, they might say, well, I've never killed somebody, or I've never done this, that, or the other, and they'll almost put their actions on a scale. And if their good actions outweigh their bad scales, or their actions outweigh somebody else's bad actions, they come to this conclusion, I'm a good person. But Scripture is very, very clear, and I want to look at Scripture's perspective on sin. And it's clear that Scripture sees us, humanity, as fallen and sinful in nature. So in other words, I have inherited this nature, this human nature, to a molecular, atomic, DNA level that is corrupt. It's now bent towards all sorts of desires and temptations that go contrary to the will and nature of God, and contrary to the nature in which He created us in, that image that He created us, which is now shattered as a result of sin. In Mark 7, we read about Jesus telling a group of people that what defiles them is what comes out of them. Basically, what He was relaying to them is that there's something wrong with our nature, and there's nothing we can do to save ourselves from that nature. There's no amount of good works I can try to do. I can't put my actions on a scale and say, well, my good actions outweigh the bad actions or anything like that. Jesus was saying there's something wrong with our nature. Thus, this is what makes the gospel so huge, is the fact that God Himself took on our nature, fully man, fully God, took on our nature. And as the author of Hebrews says, He was tempted in every respect that you and I are tempted, yet without sin. So in other words, this nature that we've inherited, that is wicked and corrupt and fallen and depraved to its DNA level, it's now bent towards doing all sorts of wicked things. And we have all these temptations that we battle, each one of us, that we battle these temptations. And Jesus battled those temptations as well, but He never gave in to them. He literally was obedient to the will of the Father unto death. So He was the perfect sacrifice, the unblemished sacrifice for our sins. Thus, and this is why Jesus is the only one who can save us. This is why He's the only one to eternal life, because He's the only one who has conquered our nature in resurrection. He literally has victory over the curse of sin and the nature of sin, and now offers new life in Him. So if you're sitting there thinking, well, we're just good people, deep down inside, that we're good and we can do good things, or you're sitting there ranking your sins, in other words, comparing them to somebody else's sins, and saying, well, I haven't done that, so I must be good because my bad actions don't compare to that person's bad actions. I want you to approach Scripture, and I want you to hear what Scripture has to say. It says, listen, you're a sinful person in your very nature. You're bent towards all sorts of wicked things. And what Scripture says is to come to Jesus. There's good news that you can be saved from that nature, saved from that destruction and that sin, if you would repent and come to Jesus and just surrender your life to His Lordship. And He'll give you a new spirit. And He will save you within, and then He promises that one day you too will share in His resurrection to a molecular, atomic, DNA level, and you will inherit this new body, no longer susceptible to sin and suffering and to all sorts of those wicked temptations and everything like that. So I challenge you to change your perspective on the topic of sin.